Hey guys, allowed to do this video here. I'm normally not the one to, I'm not dirty laundry on social media, but this has got to be said. I don't appreciate my family, even my sister for that matter, trying to ruin my and my wife's reputations all because of hearsay. No, I'm tired of her. She just mad that she don't know that my mom got my grandmother to sign the house over to her. And as soon as whenever my grandmother passes, I get the house. She did that because Renee, my sister, is an idiot. She always has been a money grubber. She always has been one. Not going to lie. She'll spend all kinds of money. She bought a treadmill. She never used it. She bought all kinds of things. When she got hired at where I worked at in 2012, she decided she wanted to get her a house. I told my mom and dad it's the stupidest idea ever. Why would you get a house? I knew she wasn't going to last there long. I know that for a fact. Yeah. She only lasted 9 months. About the summer of 2013, she was already gone out of Walmart. I was in there enjoying my years. I worked hard, and I did a good job. I never did ask a dime from my mom and my dad for nothing. I never did. I never did ask for anything like that. I lived in their house, yes, but the problem with it is, I was trying to get I got a car so I could build credit up. So when I build credit up, I can get a house of my own somewhere. But it didn't turn out that way. I didn't think, figuring 4 or 5 years, well, in 6 years, I'll be married. In 2019, I got married to a beautiful wife, which a lot of my family don't like. Didn't like it when I married her. I know she didn't. I know my sister don't like her. Well, I could care less what she thinks. I just don't care about it. When I lost my job last year, I was down in the dumps. Nobody was there for me but my wife and my inner kids. You'd think my sister and my brother-in-law would try. My brother-in-law would try to help me get a job where he worked at Summit Plastics. You'd be wrong. He never did once try to help. He said, go put your application in. I'll get you hired. I put my application in December. No callback. Then July, he told me to go do it again. I did it again. This time I have witnesses saying I did do it because, of course, they was with me. My wife was with me. I did the job, application. And then I got home. My brother-in-law there said the outlandish, stupidest thing he ever seen. He said that, they'll be calling me for an interview. And he said that in front of my wife, her kids, and my mom and dad, and my grandmother. He blatantly told a lie. He already admit. Why don't you just come on, just admit it? You don't want me working with you. That's just fine. I don't want to work with your ass anyway. You're out your damn mind. I don't believe your ass. Or shit. I don't get why you can't use my sister can't just pick up the phone and ask me or my wife What's going on? She ought to know how my grandmother is. She can lie to people. My grandmother lies all the time. But it's gonna catch up to her. That's why everybody's telling me, you better start recording her and make sure you get everything on video, because when they say something again, you got the proof. And they'll say, oh, okay. So you're lying. I think she already done got in trouble. My grandma done got in trouble. And plus, I think my sister got in trouble too, because all of a sudden, my sister's all up there being apologetic like crazy, apologizing like crazy. Yeah, I'm sure. You screwed up. You're the ones that screwed up. You try to ruin people. I could do the same thing and ruin your life. Make your life a living hell. Hell, I could sue you for what you did in 2013, wrecking my car, and thought the motherfucker that he's going to, my brother-in-law and my sister, they borrowed my car. Even though I told them they couldn't use it, they still used it. I said, okay, I'm going to come back and get the car in a few days. They said, okay. They was going to go to Macomb in the Buick they had at the time. Then they came back to their house, jumped in my car, and wrecked it. Thinking it's going to get an easy payday. Get some money out of it. But joke's on them. They didn't have no uninsured motorist. You see, I could have sued their ass and put them in jail for that shit. They stole my car. I could have said, hey, they stole my car, was stolen. Car reported stolen. And yeah, I could have reported that car stolen. I could have had their asses in the jail cell right now. They wouldn't have to worry about shit. But my sister thinks she's going to try to be a goody-goody now. Okay. I got stuff on you. You ruined my dad's credit. You tried to ruin my credit. You tried to take out credit cards in my name. I know you probably did. She probably did. Because I have evidence someone opened a Walmart credit card in my account and opened it up and spent $3,700 on it. I never had a Walmart card at all. I don't have credit cards. I don't have a bill like that. Plus my wife, it's funny. She wants to start her shit, and I can start some shit too. You wrecked my car. I should just went ahead and press charges on your ass for damages. I should have sued your ass for damages. You owe me a car. That's all you do. You owe me a car. My sister owes me a car for what she did. I didn't tell her to take that car for a ride or any damn thing. She just came over there and stole it out of my hand. I didn't know she had the car. I come home from work one day and the car's gone. I said, why the car ain't here? So Renee said you wouldn't mind taking it. I ain't told her no damn thing about taking that car. No. Karma's gonna be a bitch one day. She's gonna get what's coming to her. Thank you for watching.